That was another go around with the track. So you might say, well, why don't you put a fuel filter in line? Well, as a matter of fact, these particular tractors, all they had was a sediment bowl, clear glass bowl on the other side, comes right off the bottom of the tank. And if you look in that bowl, you won't see anything in it. And I did cut the line and I put a filter in it right here. And ever since they started importing these cheap, junk Chinese fuel filters, I have had to pull more carburetors apart and clean dirt out of them since using them. So that's my truck, my tractor, a couple different trucks, a couple different cars. Why do they even bother? I'm going to go ahead and just let some of this blow out of here. Still a bunch of water. While that's doing its thing, I'm going to show you the sediment bowl. That's right here. Get my tripod all over everything. When you look inside there, it's nice, clean, and clear. When you look at the reflection coming off the paint there, you can see the beads of water rolling across the top. So apparently there's a bunch of water in the fuel line still. And then when you look at the gas down in there, it's all milky and cloudy. And no wonder it wouldn't start. Will eat up my brand new paint with all that gas on it too. Whatever it takes, make her run. This is the perfect opportunity to rinse all the dirt out of my funnel. Well, I decided to pull the sediment bowl. And what I found out was it looked clean and clear because it was full of water. I already dumped it out and then I opened the valve and took this sample of it. So we're running 30% water here.
I wish that tractor could run on 30% water.
So, what I shall do now keep taking samples of this. Still full of water. I might as well just drain the tank. I don't know how much is in there. Oh, about 3 gallon or so. Sample time. Still nice and cloudy. I think I might be able to get away with what's in there. I really don't feel like dumping away 3 gallons of gas. Where's my bowl? I'll take this opportunity to remove my overspray. Of course, now I still have all that water in the fuel line. It's got to come out of here, so I got to go drain, turn this on, and let it push it through. Nope. Ain't gonna do it. I thought for sure all the water had been separated to the bottom of the tank. But the minute I turn that fuel on, this is what it does inside the bowl. Great. Okay. Dump it all! Plastic jugs, give it a little time to settle and separate. I can pour it off and reclaim it.
Well, here we are at the end, and you can see that what's coming out of there now is just water. So, there wasn't much point in trying to save what I could, just dump it all out and start over again. So once that's done dripping, then we'll put a couple of gallons of fresh gas in there with 3 or 4 ounces of acetone. Run that through the new fuel line, or run the new fuel through the line, is what I should say. Take it from there.
Nothing's going to heat up your fresh spray paint faster than acetone. So I highly recommend you don't try pouring right out of the can. Now, if you've never seen one of these gas cans, I highly recommend them. You have to push that button in to get anything out of them. Keeps you from pouring gas all over your chainsaws and your lawnmower. They're expensive. First time I ever used the one that I finally broke down and bought, it was worth every dime. Yeah, we'll run a little bit of that through there. Oh yeah. Clean and clear.
Purged my fuel line coming down to the carburetor, and because of the camera, oops, you don't get to see that. But what you will get to see, this is the last can of gasoline that I ran through there. We had to do about almost a quart until we got it clear like that. So now that it's clear, we should have clear fuel all the way through, and this thing should start.
Charger on. Boost. Neutral. Park brake, choke, contact. That's what we're looking for. And that's not what we're looking for. What was that all about? When it popped, it blew 3 spark plug wires off the distributor cap and the coil wire. I ain't never seen nothing like that before in my life. By golly, it smells like something exploded down inside that distributor. You know what I bet it was? I filed those points, and then to get the grit out from in between the points, I hit it with carburetor cleaner, and then I blew it with the air gun. So it must have sat down in behind that, underneath that breaker plate. I ain't never seen nothing like that before in my life! You gotta see this.
I kid you not. When it popped, it blew those spark plug wires and coil wire right out of that cap. But the cap couldn't go nowhere because the clips were on it. Well, get it back on there and try it again.
It can't do that again, the fuel's all gone. Let's see, 1, 3, 4, coil, 2, let's try this again, shall we? Uh-oh. Better check for spark. Yeah, got spark. fuel ignition compression. It'd help if I stuck my rotor button back in. Let's see what happens. That's what we're looking for. Carb mixture later. I don't have a water pump on it. So in the next episode, we're going to head over to Tony the Flying Dutchman, who rebuilds water pumps, and see how he came along with rebuilding the one that's on this. I had to take the front end off. So if you got to take the whole front end off your tractor just to change the water pump, chances are when you got it off, you should go through your water pump anyway. So that's what I did. So here we go. She's up and running. So until the next Redneck Restorations This Old Tractor episode, I'm Jeff Bradshaw.